Hi everyone! Today we're going to check out different types of chargers for solar watches. Not only the ones that use a cable, like the GBDH1000 or GPRH1000, those solar watches that charge by cable, but also chargers for any kind of solar watch. Lately, more and more people have been using these LED type chargers, so I brought three types of LED units. We look at each one and compare their differences. This one is really old, over 10 years old. They used to sell them like this, and they weren't specifically made for charging watches. They were just for lighting or whatever, until one day someone tried putting their watch under it, and it ended up fully charged. You can put 3 AAA batteries in it, but the light output is pretty weak. Too bad, around 5000 lux. A few years ago, I bought this LED unit from the brand Coolfire. This one is better. It has over 5000 cells on the side, which says a lot about the product. It has a slider switch to turn it on and off, and it has a micro USB connector, which is kind of outdated now and not very common anymore. The device doesn't have a built-in rechargeable battery, so you always need to keep it plugged into a cable for it to stay on. Or at the bottom, it has a slot for 2 batteries. Up to that point, it sounds like it has several advantages, but actually not really, because if you put batteries in it, instead of all 22 LEDs turning on, only 4 LEDs light up, and with just those 4 lights, your watch is basically not going to charge. When it's plugged into a cable, all 22 LEDs turn on and give a total of 50,000 lux, which is pretty good. Besides the micro USB connector, you can also plug in the DC coaxial connector. The one I show you in the picture. This type of connector is one of the most common for powering LED strips or LED panels using an AC adapter. Then we have this LED panel. This one just came out recently. It has pros and cons as well. Compared to the previous one, this one gives 50,000 lux, while this one lets you choose between 20,000 and 40,000 lux. So its maximum output is a bit lower than this. The light here is yellow, and this one is white. But the advantage of this newer one is that it uses USB-C, which is super common and easy to find anywhere. If you lose the cable, you just grab your phone's cable and plug it in. That's it! Much more practical. It's also lighter and you don't deal with the batteries with only power up for LEDs, which again won't charge your watch effectively. Let's plug them in. Here's the white light. 50,000 lux, just one mode. And this one, when you turn it on, gives 40,000 lux, and pressing it again gives 20,000 lux. Which one should you choose? It depends on you. Both are good. This one has 10,000 more lux than the other, but the difference isn't huge, and charging time is pretty much the same. When we charge the watch, we place it like this. This watch is completely dead, and we'll see how long it takes for it to activate. With this device, it might feel like it slides a bit, but both devices come with circular adhesives, so the watch won't slide around. Keep this in mind, to reach the minimum level needed for the watch to turn on, you need around 2 to 4 hours of strong sunlight, sometimes even more, and to fully charge it, you need around 24 hours or more. With LED panels of about 50,000 lux, I've tested that you only need 20 to 30 minutes to activate the watch, and about 3 hours to fully charge it. Obviously, this can vary from model to model, but that's the average. The watches I've charged are the Mudmaster GWG1000, GWG2000, Casioak GAB2100, and since these have similar charging patterns, I assume other solar models would be similar as well. What's left to test are solar watches that charge by cable, whether they charge the same or take longer. Another thing I've noticed is that after around 40 minutes of charging, the watch feels slightly warm. This is normal, and I haven't seen any downside. It doesn't heat up a lot, just a little, so it shouldn't damage the resin, the band, or any part of a G-Shock. When you search solar watch charger on Amazon, you'll see these LED panels we've been looking at. But if you scroll down, we'll find something interesting. A cool fire version that now uses USB-C, and if you check, it has the same number of cells. I would obviously recommend this one, since I've read many positive comments about the brand in different forums. Cool fire seems to have a good reputation. I wanted to share this because many people who have issues with their solar watches sometimes just leave them unused, sitting around, because you need patience and a place with strong light, etc. These LED panels are a really good option. Consider it. Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to leave a like. Thanks and see you next time.